from the historic Ryman Auditorium in Nashville, Tennessee. It's Bill Engvall's new All-Stars of Country Comedy, starring Bill Engvall, featuring Country Comedy All-Stars Larry the Cable Guy, Craig Hawksley, Earl David Reed, Lonesome Dave, and Killer Beaz. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Bill Engvall.
And welcome to the second edition of the new All-Stars of Country Comedy, coming to you once again from the historic Ryman Auditorium in Nashville, Tennessee. Well, here we are in the year 2000, man. I'm so glad the 90s are over. I tell you what, I hated the 90s. Because the 90s, we started using the word awesome, but we use it wrong. You know, we'll say stuff like, "Oh, your car is awesome," or "Your yard looks awesome." That's not awesome. Awesome is defined by Webster's Dictionary as anything that leaves you in awe and wonder. Like winning the lottery. Twice. That's awesome. Getting a call from the IRS saying you've been audited and they owe you $50,000. That's awesome. Ladies, you wake up tomorrow morning, the newspaper headline reads, "Scientists have discovered a way for men to experience childbirth." That'd be awesome. Getting invited to the Playboy Mansion on trampoline night. That's awesome. And I started thinking, what would be awesome for me? What would leave me in awe and wonder? And it'd have to be, if I finished this show tonight and I went back to my hotel room, and Shania Twain met me at my door wearing nothing but a fuzzy bathrobe and holding a note from my wife that said, "Have a good time." That would be awesome. Y'all ready to have a good time tonight? All right, this comedian was raised on a pig farm and ran for president. He's appeared on Evening at the Improv, Comic Strip Live, VH1, and Showtime. He also does daily syndicated radio commentaries. Please welcome Larry the Cable Guy.
Appreciate it. How you doing? All right, good to see you. I apologize about my outfit. I just come from a wedding. Yeah. Boy, I had a horrible nightmare last night. I dreamt I drunk the world's largest margaritas and woke up this morning, they were salt on the toilet lid. Oh, man. Thank God I didn't eat the worm in there. I'll tell you that much right there. I tell you what, boy, I tell you. That's right, but good to see you. Good to see you. I tell you what, I live in Florida. I live down there. Living down in Florida, you been down there? My brother lit a lot of drugs down in Miami. I don't like it. I was down there broad daylight, car drive by. I said, "Do you want some cocaine?" I like, "No, officer." You know, it's ridiculous. I don't like it down there. I don't like it down there. My brother's down there. He says to his wife the other day, he said, "What do you want for Valentine's Day?" She said, "A divorce." I know, he was like, "Man, I wasn't planning on spending quite that much this year, you know." So, he's in a lot of trouble. He's in a lot of trouble. I used to know this girl, I liked her. She had one breast bigger than the other. It was crazy. She got a wet t-shirt contest to come home with the first and third place out there at that deal. I tell you what, I was really proud of her. Really proud of her. I love women, though. I tell you, I went dancing the other day with a girl, had a wooden leg, and I spun her the wrong direction, and she growed taller. You believe that? Growed taller. Well, I was watching TV the other day, and they got all them talk dirty numbers and 900 numbers. You ever call them? Yeah, I'm the only one that calls that number. All right. That's a rip-off, them 900 numbers, I tell you. I got a girl that stuttered that cost me $1,700. You believe that? Boy, I enjoy being here. I was riding my horse the other day, and it broke a leg, and I had to shoot it. And now it's got a broken leg and a gunshot wound. I don't know what you're supposed to shoot them for, you know, but I guess it helps in the healing process or something. I ain't sure, but whatever it is. But I tell you, I do love women. I can't find nobody. Go out. We went out with this girl from Dalton, Georgia, good looking. Had one of them beauty marks on her cheek, like old Cindy Crawford. And we get to the kissing. I was looking at it. It was a tick. Oh, man, I tell you. What the hell? You believe that? Oh, I tried to burn it out with a lighter, you know. I like it. She was like, "You're singeing my beard," you know. So, that's ridiculous. I took this gal out a while ago for Valentine's Day, figured to do something nice. And took her up flea market up there looking good, boy, I tell you what, shorty shorts, a hind end sticking out, half shirt, ball cap. Dang it, gum, I was looking good up at the flea market, I tell you what. Boy, I was looking good at the flea market. You ever see them mood rings? Boy, they're pretty good. They work. I tell you, when she was in a good mood, it was blue. And when she was in a bad mood, it made a red mark upside my head right here. It's a pretty good ring, I tell you. It's a pretty good ring. But I wanted to marry her, and I was asking my grandma about getting married, because she'd been married about 50 years, you know. And I said, "What do you think about me getting married?" And grandma said, "Shut the door, I'm trying to poop." You know, so I guess I asked her at the wrong time, you know, but then she kept talking. "What do you want to marry her for? You barely even know that girl." You know, I tell you. I was like, "What in the world? I'll let you finish the chalupa in there. That's ridiculous." That's the thing about relatives. They don't carry you in the bathroom. They walk right in on you, brother, sister, you in there, you know. They walk in. "I'm going to get my hair sprayed." "Yeah, man, it stinks in here." "Well, no kidding, Sherlock." "What do you think's coming out of me? Pop-Tarts? Good Lord." "I mean, you heard me going like that. What do you think I'm doing, lifting weights in here? It's ridiculous. You ain't got to be head cashier at the Walmart to figure out what I'm doing in here." I got some crazy relatives, I tell you what. Crazy relatives. Took this gal out a while ago, likes all the sexy britches. You ever see the sexy britches? Boys at the Victoria's Secret, they got a lot. You ever see, they got a deal called crotchless britches. You ever seen them? I couldn't believe it. Under britches with holes in the crotches. There's a woman paid $24 for one pair of crotchless britches. I was like, "Good Lord, I got a whole drawer full of them at the house back there." I tell you what, I got none but crotchless britches. I'm sitting on a truck payment back there. Then she sends me out to get the edible panties. You ever see the edible? Who thought of that? Couple sitting at home bored with their sex life. "What do you want to do tonight?" "Man, let me eat your shorts." "Get me a glass of milk. I might have to wash them now." There's a gal I was seeing a while back like stuff like that. And I got her 5 pair of the strawberry eating britches. And I bought her 5 pair because I always end up eating a couple pair on the way down to her house, you know. Hey, pretty good. I tell you what, that's right. Thank God they don't make them in biscuits and gravy, I tell you what. Boy, I'd be getting fat just on under britches. Doctor said, "You gained 10 pounds last week." "I ate a lot of britches last week, I gotta tell you. They need to make some fat-free britches. They ought to come out with some snack well panties. That's right. Honey, I'm on a diet. Put on some fruit roll-ups, would you? Do something. Rub some fat-free jello on your thighs. Help out a little bit. I'm trying to lose some weight over here." It's ridiculous, ain't it? But I was running for president. There's just a lot of stuff. Irritates me. The news media don't know what they're talking about. Watching some show the other day, girl comes on there, interrupt my show. Learn how to protect yourself tonight at 10. What if something happened to me at 7:30, 8 o'clock at night there? Now what do I do? Ain't that something? Computers is ruining this country. Let me tell you something. I bought a computer. You know what? I might as well bought a $2,200 deck of cards. Alright? I kid. All I do is play solitaire on that computer. Then they go, yeah, but you can get dirty pictures on the monitor. Now, what a waste of time that is. Dirty pictures on the monitor. Takes an hour to get a picture on there. Now, there I sit like an idiot, naked on a folding chair. You know, 2:30 in the morning. It's embarrassing. They finally threw me out of Kinko's about 4 o'clock in the morning down there. They had it, man. Yep, they had it with me, I tell you. People is suing cigarette companies because they're getting sick. Well, that's ridiculous. It says on the box you're going to get sick. I'm going to sell Hustler magazine for giving my wrist carpal tunnel. How's that sound right there? Ridiculous. Does that make sense? Well, it don't make no sense. There's a lot of dumb people out there, too, I tell you. A lot of dumb people. You want to see some dumb people? Go to the fast food restaurant. Get you 3 cheeseburgers and some french fries. Your order's going to come $6.90. Give the fella in there $10 and a dime. Kick back and watch the fun begin at the fast food restaurant. You like NASCAR? I like NASCAR a lot. You know, they's trying to make the NASCAR get rid of Winston Cup, you know. They want to do another sponsor because it's offensive to Winston. Well, what in the world? Who's going to sponsor NASCAR? Stay Free Mini Pads? Well, that'd be something, wouldn't it? Well, we got 43 cars in the Kotex Cup this year. There's Jeff Gordon in the number 24 Strawberry Deuce Chevy Monte Carlo. That's right. How'd you get tickets to the Tampon 200? Well, we pulled some strings and we got some pretty good seats on there. Get her done, that's right. That's right. Well, God bless you. God bless you. I'm just going to tell you real quick before I get out of here. Remember this. Everybody makes fun of a redneck until their car breaks down. All right? That's right. Thanks a lot, y'all. Get her done. Appreciate it. That'd be Larry the Cable Guy.
So these are professional comedians here, sir.
Do you have
sir?
A pass at all?
God love you. When my truck got stuck last Thursday, she hooked the chain up and squeezed her butt cheeks together and pulled that truck right out of that ditch. Yeah. Look at these.
Still in four-wheel drive.
That's right.
Still in
these is some truck hauling thugs.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, please welcome a comic who was born midway through the last century and has been doing comedy ever since. He's worked everywhere from Maine to California, but he's originally from St. Louis, Missouri. Please welcome Craig Hawksley.
Thank you. I haven't always been this funny. I used to sell tires, but I got fired for arguing with the customers. People were constantly saying things to me like, tires are tires, man. With a little patience and a coupon, I can get a set of tires cheap. Well, you know what? With a little bit of initiative and a bumper jack, they're free. So think about that stuff. Think about this. Science just invented this drug, and the reason they invented it was to reduce the size of the male prostate gland. But they're finding out it has a side effect. It cures male pattern baldness. It shrinks your head to fit the hair you still got left. Yeah. Yeah, instead of Alberto VO5, just put a little dab of Preparation A to take care of it. I saw a pair of pants at the Big and Tall men's shop, size 60-28. 60-28. That means when you're laying down, you're taller than when you're standing up. You pretty much have to assume that you have feet. I'm a married man, happily married man with three daughters. Thank you very much. Yeah. Thank you. Yeah. I live in the same house with four women. So I just pee in the yard. The grass don't grow and the snow don't stick in my yard. Dogs don't stray in my yard. Those boundaries are marked. Three daughters. And you know, people ask me if that's a problem for a father not to have a son. And my oldest daughter asked me about it recently. Her name's Craig Jr. She's 12. Her little sisters are 10 and 8. And smart, too, you know. Really intelligent kids, like all your kids are, too. My 12-year-old reads like an adult, and the little ones are trying to keep up. I remember a couple years ago when my youngest one was in kindergarten. We were all in the car driving under a bridge, and on the wall of the viaduct, somebody had conveniently spray-painted a word for her to spell. And she jumped all over it. Dad! What does F-mm-mm-mm spell? And I could see my little baby sweet face looking at me in that rearview mirror, and I said, cat. And my middle daughter goes, sound it out, Dad. I didn't expect that. When I had kids, I did not expect that these little clones of myself running around in my yard. You know, with my attitude and my mannerisms. You know, and it's little things. The way the 8-year-old holds a can of beer. And you know what? Kids don't listen. Kids imitate. My wife and I had that point hammered home to us recently. Apparently, we have been arguing a lot in the car about the way I drive. Yeah, and we didn't realize it, so we went to the school picnic and we got on the bumper cars with the kids where they got to drive us. Role play 101. My middle kid drove, she drove like me. I sat in the passenger side, I reacted the way my wife does. She was like, hey! And then when she saw me looking at her, she goes, what? The son of a bitch cut me off, Dad. Thank you, Sesame Street. Do you know what, though? They're great kids, and I've never had... Well, I take that back. One time I had trouble at school. I had to go up there. A couple of years ago, I had a spelling bee, and my second grader had a little trouble with the word cat. But you know what, I'm still a guy living in the last century. I gotta say that, the new cars confuse me. I'm the guy who comes up to the parking lots of the new cars and goes, you left your lights on. And you go, they'll shut off all by themselves. But there's a good reason for this. I'm the proud owner of a 1969 Chevy Nova. See, I knew you people would understand this. I've owned that car since day one. You guys will appreciate this. Everything on that car is broken. Do you ever have a car like that? This car, I'll tell you what, there's so many things broken on it, nobody but me can drive it. So I'm gonna show you, if you ever need to borrow my car, this is what you have to go through every single time you go anywhere. Now you gotta take the ignition key out and you gotta bend it in your teeth. And then you curve it 3 notches into the hole. Push up to the right and in. Pump the gas 103 times. If you lose count, you have to wait an hour before you can try it again. You hold the gear shift lever halfway between drive and neutral. That window's covered with plastic. And then I go through all that trouble, and then when I get where I want to go, the engine won't shut off. No, you don't understand. I have the keys in my hand, and I am walking away from the vehicle. And it'll just keep running. Like a spoiled child. You know, and I'm not going to turn around, because that's what it wants me to do. And the other day, I got halfway into the grocery store. Some guy caught me. He goes, "Man, your car's still running out there." I go, "Well, it's one of those newer models. It'll shut off all by itself in 5 minutes. Thank you, folks.
Craig Hawksley, ladies and gentlemen.
I finally opened for you.
I did, didn't I?
Mom and Dad, I'm at the Grand Ole Opry. Mrs. Hawksley's boy has done all right.
Earl David Reed is a 2-time Star Search winner. You've seen him on NBC's Friday Night Videos and the Arsenio Hall Show. He's also the morning radio personality on WRKZ Cat Country 106.7. Please welcome country comedian, trendsetter, Earl David Reed.
Yes, 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 yes. I'm just surprised to see all of you as you are to see one of me. Yes. Woo! This is better than the first time I performed, though. The first time I performed was at a comedy club. I didn't get on stage till 2 o'clock in the morning. By then, there were only 2 people left in the audience. As soon as I got on stage and started my act, they just got up and left. And I cried all the way home. I just couldn't take it anymore. I had to stop and talk to somebody about it. So I stopped at my parents on the way home, and I said, "Mom, Dad, why'd y'all leave? I was struggling out there. Damn." My name is Earl David Reed, and I tell you, I love country music, but I gotta tell you, country music's not too popular with black people. I remember the first time I went to my first concert, I was walking around going, "Hey, there's something different here. Oh, dang, it's me!" A lot of stuff happening around traveling and everything like that. Boy, I'll tell you, man, oh man, I use the terminology black. I gotta be careful. I don't know if that's politically correct, and hey, I don't wanna offend myself, you know. Black, African-American, Negro, screw it. From now on, I'm just going to be Swiss Mocha. That's what I'm going to be. Forget it. Same black guy with just a hint of chocolate, you know? I don't care who you ever are. You ever go for a job interview, write down Swiss Mocha on the application. You may not get the job, but you'll definitely get the interview. Well, you're not really qualified, but hell, we had to see what a Swiss Mocha person looked like. I was going to wear my cowboy hat tonight, but I decided not to do it. There are a lot of cowboy hats out there, and they all look good. They all look good except for one. That one that's got the big feather right here on the front. You ever see one of those? Only one guy's ever wore a hat like that and looked good. That's Richard Petty. Richard Petty, the only guy. I'm trying on cowboy hats. There's a guy next to me trying cowboy hats on. He puts one with a big feather right here. He goes, "You know what? I look just like Richard Petty." I'm going, "Lo, you look like you walked into the ass end of a turkey." All your hat needs is a little chin strap with a gobbler on it, and you're good to go. Driving around today, I gotta tell you, man, road construction is starting to kill me. I hate when they take three lanes and bring it down to one lane, you know what I'm talking about? And they have those cement dividers on each side of the lane, and you're driving down the middle of the road, you're like, ah, trying not to hit the wall. Are you scared like me? I'm actually tightening my ass up, you know, because I think it's gonna help bring the sides of the car in, you know? I'm like, ah! I still hit the wall, but now I can crack walnuts with my ass, so that's, Laugh if you want, when the holidays come around, you'll be calling me up to help you make nut bread, so... I spit when I talk. Did you notice that? I'm really sorry. I just saw it go, woo! Everyone else is laughing. This woman's sitting there going... You ever notice when people talk and they spit at you, you try to ignore it, and you go, yeah, we going to the game tomorrow, and, It's worse when food flies out of your mouth, because that leaves a mark. It's like, you know what you mean, man. You want to take these corn dogs off my forehead? I spit when I talk. I drool in my sleep. Does anyone else drool in their sleep? You spend the whole night flipping a pillow over to the dry side? So they put me up in a really nice hotel. I can't believe how nice the hotel is. You think this world's getting really strange. You know, I get on the elevator, just me and this woman. We're ethnically different. She feels really intimidated. As soon as the door shuts, we're in the same elevator. As soon as the door shuts, she looks over at me, really stupid, starts wrapping her purse around her arm. And I'm thinking, how stupid is this? I mean, even if I were the kind of person that wanted to steal her purse, where the hell am I going? I'm in the elevator. But he goes, give me that. Could you push four, please? I love Nashville, boy, because I love that Southern accent. If I could meet a woman with a Southern accent, I'd marry her in a second, boy. Woo. But yeah, you gotta be careful though, because if you don't pay attention, you can look like an idiot when they talk to you. I was in a restaurant, all I wanted was a potato. The waiter didn't say, how would you like the potato? He just yells at me how I could have it. So I go, I like a potato. He goes, masturbate! Now what he was saying was mash or baked. I know that today. About 2 weeks ago, I thought he was yelling something else at me that I thought was a little bit too drastic for a potato. Like, you, I want a potato. You go, masturbate. Finally, I snapped. I go, for a potato? I said, skip that. Give me the rice. Guy next to me is eating a potato. I go, I know what you did with that. Shame on you. I don't get to date that much. I'm single. I blame my parents because they never taught me anything about sex. I remember the first time I had sex with this girl, her method of birth control is one of those diaphragms. You ever see one of those? Looks like a giant condom. And I got all scared because I thought I had to wear it. I'm going, no way am I going to fit that thing, no way. Yes, I know I'm a Swiss mocha guy, but cut me a break, I'm not going to fit it. Oh, man. I like the South because it doesn't snow that much in the South. Snows a little bit, not where it gets really cold. Anyone from where it's really cold? Where it's really cold? Where are you from? Chicago? It don't get cold there. It get dang cold. They just put that in your weather report. What's the temperature going to be, Mom? Dang cold. Back to you, Bob. You know, it's so cold in Chicago in the wintertime. If you walk outside, you see a guy with a push broom sweeping up nipples. That's how cold it is. It's like... I was there like, can I help you? I'm like, yes, can I have those two black nipples there, please? Oh, you need one of them? Then give me that nipple and the old milk gut. I don't care. I just have to get inside. It's just too cold. Unbelievable. Hey, I'll tell you why I like Garth Brooks so much. Like Garth Brooks? I'll tell you why. I'll tell you right now, man. You know why? Because he doesn't sell out his songs. No matter how many songs he has, no matter how famous he is, he doesn't use them in like cheap commercials. And that's good. Because Garth has a lot of songs, and I don't know if I could see a lot of Garth Brooks commercials songs and commercials, man. That would drive me crazy. Can you imagine you turn on your TV and hear him go, hi, this is Garth Brooks for Garth Brooks Condoms. You know, guys, whether you're at the dance or the beaches of Cheyenne, you need to protect yourself so you don't end up the river. That's why I use Garth Brooks Condoms. That's right, fellas. Don't be shameless. Protect your friends in low places. And cover up your long neck bottle. I'm Earl David Reed. Thank you so much. Thank you.
Earl David Reed, ladies and gentlemen.
I'm so thirsty.
All right, he's one of the top country acts on the West Coast, but he's originally from North Carolina. Please welcome Lonesome Dave.
Thank you, I wrote that myself. Good crowd, good people, a lot of good-looking women in Nashville. You guys realize that, don't you? Look at that. I married a very beautiful Latina woman. I ain't making this up, y'all. My wife's from Dominican Republic. She talks like this. My wife could beat the crap out of me. It's like being married to Scarface. I come home, baby, I'm home. What the hell had you been? You know what kills me about my wife? She gets pissed off at my mother from North Carolina because she can't understand her accent. She's on the phone. Let me tell you something, baby. You're going to have to learn to pronounce your words. I learned one thing from my wife, too, fellas. Never share a bathroom with a woman. That's a nightmare. If she'll try to share that bathroom with you, she will not succeed. Come on in, baby. Spread out. But these are my five drawers. My six cabinets. And for your things, I cleared out this cup. That's how I know I'm never gonna be able to leave her. I'm gonna look too stupid. One day I'm gonna snap. That's it, baby, I'm out of here. Taking my cup. Because women do think we're stupid. You realize that, don't you, fellas? But ladies, we are not stupid. If we were stupid, we couldn't come up with those good excuses we're coming up with all the time. Right, boys? Yeah. She's like, why'd you put my picture in your closet? Well, that ain't a closet, baby. That's a shrine. That's why I got all your crap up there. Thank you very much. Thank you, I wrote that myself. Good crowd, good attitude, good people. Y'all having fun here tonight. Look at this. All right. You're a courteous crowd, I appreciate that. Be courteous, it's good in life. I gave you a perfect example. The other day I'm trying to pass this guy on the shoulder of the road. Chick with a flat tire cut me off. I let her in. I'm courteous. Hell, I figure if we can lick Y2K, we can figure out a way to convert sexual energy into electrical energy. That way you got a good relationship, you got free power. Give a new meaning to keeping up with the Joneses, huh? Instead of being the guy with the nicest car, you want to be the guy with the brightest Christmas tree. The best thing about it is women wouldn't have an excuse anymore. I'm sorry I got a headache, honey, but we got to keep the refrigerator going. As I say, be who the hell you are. That's what I say. Be who the hell you are. My wife trying to get me to take my cowboy hat off, wear a little earring. I ain't going to do that. You fellas want to wear an earring? Wear that earring proud. Be who the hell you are. My daddy would have kicked your butt. I tried wearing an earring, couldn't get past that face you gotta make when you put it on in the morning. That little earring face. How the hell do these guys do that? I used to think these guys are wimps, then they started piercing their nipples. These guys are real men. I can't even see John Wayne doing that, can y'all? I can't see John Wayne going, well, somebody come over here and drive a stake through my nipple. And hold the shot for a second, I gotta get my earring in. Listen, I'm so happy to be here at the Ryman, I cannot tell you. And I'm gonna do a little song for you folks. Yeah. But before I do, I want you to remember three things about my performance here tonight. Be courteous to one another. Be who the hell you are. And keep your Christmas trees well lit.
I'm Lonesome Jay. Thank y'all very much.
That'd be Lonesome Dave right there.
We're saying about being lonesome answering machines. Who wants to come home and find out nobody thought about you that day? I first got my machine, I was ticked off. I thought everybody's calling me and hanging up. That's just me checking the messages that don't have. Look at this. I'm getting a laugh from the cameraman. One stage late. This is my crowd. You and me and the camera.
This next fella got his start in show business playing blues guitar in Jackson, Mississippi. For 18 years, he's been in the trenches of the comedy club circuit, and he's a familiar face from Showtime, the Nashville Network, Entertainment Tonight, and Rolling Stone magazine. Good friend of mine. Please welcome Killer Beaz.
Wow, bless your hearts, man. Thank you very much.
Save him!
Wow. Y'all, this is cooler than the other side of the pillar. It's great to be out here tonight, y'all. I am Killer Beaz. My real name is Truett S. Beasley Jr. Yeah, thanks, Dad. I lived most of my life in Jackson, Mississippi. If y'all have never been to Mississippi, folks, save up. Save up, go for that second honeymoon. Take jumper cables, get in free. Take a light bulb and trick them. Take your wife out to eat, y'all. There's a restaurant at home that's so cheap there's no shakers on the table. The middle of the room has a salt lick. Grew up in Mississippi, then we moved to Alabama because we had money. Yeah, save up. What happened was the trailer come loose and rolled downhill and crossed the state line. I'm like, man, we moved. That's a heck of a note, your home come loose and pass your truck on the highway. Paperboy hauling tail to keep up. We've got a really nice home, y'all. Got brand new retreads, brand new windshield wiper blades. We've got an airbag in our trailer. We call her Nana. That's my wife's mama, y'all. I got a mother-in-law. I mean a big old burly, big Nana, we call her. And you don't want to mess with Nana. You cannot get away from a big woman in a trailer. Because they can stomp down on their end and tilt it up and you just slide to them. Linoleum and gravity are not your friends in a Nana fight. So I'm married as I'll get out, y'all. I got a young wife. I'm 46 years old. She's young. Her baby pictures are in color. She can whip my tail, too. My wife's a bodybuilder. Works out, pumps iron, jogs. I don't do anything, y'all. I'm lazy. I bought some tennis shoes the other day. This guy goes, Beaz, how do those shoes feel when you run in them? I said, surprised. If I'm running, my shoes are going, what's chasing us? Give them the money. It's Nana, run. My home turned into a booby trap when I got married. My wife uses my razor to hack through concrete, then she sneaks it back in the soap dish and don't tell me till half my face is peeled off. Y'all been through that? They'll go through the house, there'll be a door sticking, they'll get your razor and plane the top of it down, chop gum out of the poodle's butt hair. Scrape calluses off Nana's big old six-toed feet. Set it back in there. I used your razor to plow. You know what I learned from my wife? I found out women will smear anything on their face if you can convince them it's good for their skin. Egg whites, oatmeal, chewed up seaweed. If they'll look, if it'll pull a wrinkle out, they'll wallow in it. My wife's into mud mask, does it every night. She's done mud mask all every night for the past decade. It's reflex to her now. She don't even realize she'll have it on. She'll be feeling romantic, y'all. She'll come tipping through the den at bedtime in a little negligee, looking like a dirt clotting roller from the neck up. She's like, want to go mudding? Heck yeah, honey, let me lock my hubs in. I'll be right with you. I married Swamp Thing. I love picking on my wife, because if you can't torment your loved ones, why have them? I let my kids have a garden in the backyard. There's this little piddling garden in the backyard just so I can stand out there with them. And when my wife comes out, I'll say tacky stuff like, go get your daddy a hoe. Mine's wore out. So you got to do stuff together as married couples. My wife and I are learning to golf together. Man, line up, kick my butt, y'all. Look, golf is a hack-you-off game. You'll gladly cuss a total stranger on a golf course. You'll kill your spouse. Man, that's what sand traps are for, to hide the body. Hey, they furnish a rake. You ought to see us on the golf course. We're idiots. It's like, honey, angel, put the gun away. Now, if the ball keeps going way over there, maybe you should turn. Shut up! PMS ain't nothing compared to a par three with water. I spent so much time in the rough one day, my ball hatched. Are you my daddy? We were standing on the course. My wife goes, what's that? I said, it's a ball washer. She goes, you got to be tall. Save up. You're cute as a button. Button up. Anyway. That's Nana's girl over there. You make friends when you golf. You meet people. You know who I meet? I meet the folks that live along the golf course because I have to go in their yard to hit my ball. And there's always an icebreaker, something to talk about. Sorry to hit that bird feeder of yours. What I owe you for that? Or does that cat always lay crumpled up like that? That don't look good. Hey, guys, check it out. You wouldn't think a golf ball would bust a water pipe. Wow. Now, here's me. Here's me right here. Right here. Right here. Ma'am, don't try to get up. If it hurts when you turn your head, that could be a concussion. You know what? This is a real, real pretty kitchen. We use a 20-second rule when we golf. You know what that is, a 20-second rule? If you can run, get your tee shot, and bring it back in 20 seconds, it don't count. Improve your score, get in shape. The Paradise Lakes Nudist Resort wants me to do a show for them. Oh, yeah. Save up! Y'all, there ain't enough money around to get me on stage naked while people laugh. I'd have to have a clip on. A nudist camp, y'all. They don't just sit around and be naked. They have naked activities. Everyday life naked. It's like a little naked community. Imagine your neighborhood on Saturday mornings naked. Ah! Ugly neighbors out cutting the grass, naked. Up on a ladder painting, naked. You missed a spot, ma'am. You gonna patch that crack? Word of advice now before I get out of here for you married folks. Gentlemen, help out around the house. But learn your place. If you don't know how to cook, for God's sake, don't try to surprise your wife. Recipes were designed to get men killed. If I see Betty Crocker on the street, I'm going to whip her butt. I'm slapping flour off that big woman. She owes me money. And the kitchen. Now, this is true. In the Betty Crocker cookbook, it says, word for word, cover the bottom. Y'all, the bottom of the pan with grease. You want to know what the fireman told me? And it's tough telling your wife that her kitchen's on fire. Especially if it's your fault because you're not wanting to use the words. You're saying stuff like, honey, let's go out in the yard and look at the wedding pictures. Bring all your jewelry. And the baby. Bring the baby. No. Don't bother your mom. She's laying down. Hey, I'm Killer Beaz. Y'all have been wonderful, man. Thank you. Thank you very much, man.
Killer Beaz, ladies and gentlemen.
All right.
That was fun, man.
That was cool.
A real treat to be on stage at the Ryman Auditorium, the world-famous Ryman, and with a big, big chunk of talented people here, man. I feel really tickled to be in the mix with them.
Well, that's going to do it for this edition of the new All-Stars of Country Comedy. I'd like to thank all the talented performers who joined us today. Please keep an eye out for them, and remember, support the ongoing tradition of live comedy. Until next time, I'm Bill Engvall saying so long from Nashville!
And they are a hot crowd.
Good crowd?
Great crowd. We always get great crowds, you know? Country people are good people. They love to laugh.
Well, I'll tell you what, man. You know, I just think about all the great guys that have worked at the Ryman Auditorium. You got Hank Williams, Lefty Frizzell, all those guys. And now Lonesome Dave is one of them. I cannot be happier. I cannot be proud. It's just great.
People, this is Bill Engvall's dressing room.
Oh, I'm sorry.
We're with the Bill Engvall here. We're Bill Engvall's drivers.
Bill ain't here right now. Sure, we have him. I used to have it cut.
Brown,
just
no gray in it.
But then as I realized this was getting bigger, the more hair I let grow down this way, from the front, it looks...
Like, you look thin.
You got a cover chest here, right?
It looks like a wave of skin.
Can you believe this? A bunch of men talking about ways to look thinner for the camera?
Straight down.
Hey, I didn't need this. I'm just doing this because the other guys did. I don't need makeup.
Makeup artist who has not touched me. Not touched me. She said she didn't want to waste the sponge. But what does that mean? I don't want to sleep with her.
But I got to show you what I look like right before I got my hair cut. If you want to see redneck mullet.
Oh, no, no. Oh, no. Oh, my God.
You look like a convict.
Look at this.
Does this look anything like me?
Away from drywalling.
All right.
How old were you?
This was last year.
That was pretty cool, man. That was pretty neat. That was a great crowd, wonderful crowd, big, gigantic crowd, and it was the feel-good show of the season. Two thumbs up from Bob Dole. He saw it twice. You're laughing because I'm funny.